Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're going to look at the 7680 objective for using cipher with the encrypted file system. So in this presentation we can see how much more we can expand the functionality of Windows by additionally using the command line. So we're going to look at EFS and how we can manage that information through the command cipher. So first of all, I'm just going to encrypt a document in the normal way using the Explorer graphical utility. So I've just created a file on the desktop, and then we're going to encrypt then just this file, not the folder, and then click OK. So that file has now been encrypted. If this is the first time we've used encryption, we'll see a little wizard that will pop up in the system tray asking us to back up. But if we don't back it up, we can back it up later using the command line. So if I just jump out to the command line, if we look at the program cipher, we can always pull up help, so cipher.?, so we can see through some of the things that we can do. It's far more extensive than just using the graphical utilities. So if we're after quickly backing up the encryption keys, the public key and private key pair that was used to encrypt the file in case we lose access to the user account, we can use cipher.?. Telling us we're going to back them up and just checking that we actually initiated this. We enter the file name to backup to. So I'm just going to call it backup.pfx. Ideally we want this maybe on a different machine or a different drive, so maybe backup to a USB drive as well. And then we protect the backup and the more importantly the private key with a passphrase. So there's my backup file and I need to make sure I keep that securely and probably in a different location. So cipher.?. allows us to quickly back up our encryption keys. But if we look at cipher.?c, we can get information on what keys we use to encrypt a file, so we kind of know which backups to get. We can also use cipher.?e, and then if I put in a new document here, so I've got a Word document in here as well, so I just go new Microsoft Office Word document, so that encrypts it. Also warns us that we should actually clear the directory because some clear text information is left behind, whereas if we're using the graphical information it doesn't give us that warning. So straight away we're seeing as well the advantage of the command line. Looking in our Windows Explorer, we can see that these files are both encrypted and they're indicated that they are encrypted because they are now coloured green. Thank you for watching this and good luck in the exam.